Hi everybody, this is Jennifer with Choice Slides, and in today's Q&A, I'm going to answer a customer's question about making the soundtrack bigger in timeline mode. Now, he was having a very specific problem that you may not even run into, but the solution to his problem is actually useful for everybody. So I'm going to explain what his issue was, and then you can use the solution for yourself. So he was in timeline mode, and he had a video file that had audio in it, and that was what was causing the problem he was having. So I have a video file with audio in it and a soundtrack. I'll go into timeline mode, and this pink waveform is the audio that's attached to the video file. Down here is the soundtrack, and as you can see, the waveform is actually covered by the slider bar at the bottom. So he was wanting to work with audio points, and you can double click to add an audio point. You can right click to remove an audio point, but he was wanting to edit the audio points, but was having a really hard time because you can't see. So in a previous tutorial, I mentioned to zoom into the waveform, you can use your mouse wheel. Well, that's all good and well to make the waveform bigger, but it's still being covered by this slider bar. What I didn't mention in a previous tutorial is most of this user interface is adjustable. So if you move your mouse in between the timeline bar and the preview, you get a double arrow. If I click and drag this up, look what happens. I can make my entire timeline way bigger, and now the slider bar at the bottom does not cover the waveform. So I now have so much more room to work with these audio points. So there are two ways to make your waveform bigger in timeline mode. You can use your mouse wheel to zoom in to a specific point on the timeline. And then you can also kind of make the user interface bigger by finding that double arrow in between the timeline and the preview window right there, and then just click and drag, and that will make this entire soundtrack area a little bit bigger. So you might not run into that problem unless you have both a soundtrack and a video file with an audio in it, but even if you don't have that exact scenario, this is still helpful to know. So now you know how to make your soundtrack a little bit bigger in timeline mode.